Good morning students, Jai Swaminarayan. Today we are starting with the last topic of our longest chapter of the syllabus, that is properties of triangle. This exercise is given at the back in the appendix. Students, today this is the last formal topic of our chapter, and the topic is properties of triangle. Now, students, say this is a circle and a triangle is inscribed in the circle. So this is triangle A, B, C. The center of the circle is P, which is denoted as circumcenter. Now some basic notations. Let us understand. The side opposite to vertex A is denoted as small a, side opposite to vertex B is small b, opposite to vertex C is denoted by small c. The side opposite to vertex A is denoted by small a. The side opposite to vertex B is denoted by small b, and the side opposite to vertex C is denoted by small c. Now students, here the first rule or formula is sine rule. The first rule or formula is students, sine A. It is written in two different forms. Sine A upon small a is equal to sine B upon small b is equal to sine C upon small c is equal to some constant k. Or based on inverted, I can write A upon sin A is equal to B upon sin B is equal to C upon small sin C. That is considered as constant K only. It's 1 by K or 1 by K dash is supposed as K. Students, proof of this formula is not included in the syllabus. Now if I compare every ratio to K, then we can write A is equal to K sine A, B is equal to K sine, and C is equal to K sine C. So this is how students we apply the formula in the sums. So whenever we come across small a, b, c in the sums, students, definitely go for the application of sine formula. The second is cosine rule. The second formula is, students, cosine rule. Cos of A, remember like this, minus A square, B square plus B square upon twice B C. If it is cos A, we will have minus A square. Is cos B, then students, we will have minus B square, add A square and C square upon twice AC. And if it is cos A, we will have minus C square, A square plus B square upon twice A. So this is how, students, we are going to apply the formulas. More formula which is not given in our textbook, but you know down, and that is projection rule. Small a, small b, and small c. If it is small a, on right hand side a will not come. So we will write this b cos c plus c cos b. If it is small b, then b will not come on the right hand side. And if it is small c, then c will not come on the right hand
side.
So this is how, students, we have to remember this three part lesson. As such, this topic involves more than 20 formulas. I repeat, this topic of properties of triangle, students, involves more than 20 formulas. But in our syllabus, we have only two formulas. Third formula, projection to students, that I have written extra. It is not given in our textbook. Now, students, let us start the sums of exercise 3.5. Now, for any triangle, the small sides are given. Okay, small a, small b, and small c. And I suppose all of you know this also, perimeter is twice s is equal to a plus b plus c. I think in Heron's formula, in your 9th standard students, you have already studied this. And one more extra if you want is bb, bc, and ba are nothing but circumradius, and that is denoted by, students, this is denoted by R. And frankly speaking, this constant is equal to the diameter of the circle, which is 2R. But since that is not given in the textbook, we are not specifying, we are doing questions 1 and 2 together. For that, I note down the given sides where small a is 18. Small b is 24 and small c is 40. Okay, we are instructed to find cos a, cos b, cos c in first part. So I apply cosine rule. If small a, b, c are given students, and you are told to operate or find cos a, cos b, and cos c, and directly we use cosine. So I write according to cosine rule, cos A is equal to B square plus B square minus A square upon 2C. So B square is 24 square. C square is 30 square and A square is 18 square upon 2 into B into C. Simplify, we get 1152 upon 1440, and this is simplified to 4.5. Okay, now we find cos B, which is equal to A square plus C square minus B square upon 2AC. A square means 18 square plus 30 square minus 24 square upon 2 into 18 into 30, and this is simplified as 648 upon 1080. And this is written as 3 by 5. Now when I operate cos C, then this will be A square plus B square minus C square upon 2AB. Now A square is nothing but 18 square plus 24 square minus 30 square upon 2 into 18 into 24. And this turns out to be 0. So, the first part of the sum is easily done. Students, you are told to find cos A, cos B, and cos C. And definitely, we are given, students, small a, small b,
and small c. So I have definitely reached the cosine root.
Now, if I plot the triangle for angle A, cos A is given as 4 by 5. So this will be 3. So from this, I get sine of A is equal to 3 by 5. No need to apply any formula. I plot the triangle for angle B and I'm given cos B as 3 by 5. So this will be 4. So from this, sine of B will be 4 by 5. And if cos C is equal to 0, it implies C is equal to 5 by 2. Therefore, sine C will be sine 5 by 2 minus 1.
So, based on cos A, cos B, and cos C, students, we have found out sine A, sine B, and sine C. That's all. This is what, students, we have to do in sum number 1 and 2, students, we have already done. So, it was directly an application of cosine rule. Okay, we can use sine rule to find this, but no need to. We can directly on the basis of cos A, cos B, and cos C, students. Fine, sine A, sine B, sine C. Okay, students, now I am doing sum number 3 of exercise 3.5. Students, we are doing sum number 3 of exercise 3.5. The question starts as A plus B by C is equal to cos of A minus B by 2 upon sin C by 2. Okay, third sum. Let's start with LHS. LHS is equal to A plus B by C. Okay. Now, students, pay attention. How to proceed with the sum? This is very, very important as well as very, very interesting also. Small abc always indicates the application of sine, but sine only should be applied in this form. A is equal to k sine b is equal to k sine b, and c is equal to k sine c. So applying this, I will get k sine a plus k sine b divided by k sine c. Taking k common and getting it cancelled, we get sine a plus sine b upon sine c. Now, students, our next step is what? Or see the answer. We want a minus b by 2, and the denominator we want c by 2. This is to be converted in terms of c by 2. So, the formulas which I am applying here is s plus s, which is 2sc, and sine theta is equal to 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. I am writing the formula, students, which we are going to apply. So, s plus s is 2sc. So, 2 sine of a plus b by 2 into cos of a minus b by 2, and my denominator will be 2 sin c by 2 cos c by 2. Definitely it will be cancel. Now from this form of the answer, our answer is already there. Cos a minus b by 2 and sin c by 2 is our answer. So these two terms must be cancelling with the same aspect, and for that
a plus b plus c is equal to
pi radian or 180 degree. So a plus b can be written as pi minus c, and a plus b by 2 can be written as pi by 2 minus c by 2. So cos a plus b, sorry, sin a plus b by 2 will be sin pi by 2 minus c by 2. Sin 90 minus theta is cos theta. So this is the theta. So here students, inbuilt condition for all the sums, it is to prove for triangle, you can check. For any triangle ABC, questions 3 to 13, we have to prove. So the inbuilt condition for triangle ABC is nothing but a plus b plus c is equal to pi radian or 180 degree. So these two terms gets cancelled, and my final answer is cos a minus b by 2 upon sin c by 2, which is nothing but our RHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Hence, the sum is proved. We have proved the sum. That's all. So, in this type of sum, inbuilt condition a plus b plus c is equal to pi always works, or it is always to be considered. Now, let us read the fourth sum. A similar sum where a minus b by c is given. A similar sum, students, where a minus b by c is given. So it works as the fourth sum. LHS is equal to a minus b by c. So whenever, students, we have small a, b and c, it is nothing but application of sine rule. So taking k common, sine a minus sine b upon k times sine c. So k and k gets cancelled. Now the same formula is I am applying, but it is now s minus s, which is 2cs, and sin c is equal to 2 sin c by 2 cos c by 2. This formula I am highlighting. So 2 cos of a plus b by 2 sin of a minus b by 2 upon 2 sin c by 2 cos c by 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled. What is our answer? Sin a minus b by 2 upon cos c by 2. So definitely cos a plus b by 2 will be cos pi by 2 minus c by 2 cos 90 minus theta is sin theta. In previous sum, it was sin a plus b by 2 is equal to cos. We made interchange sin and cos. So these two terms gets cancelled. And the final answer is sin of a minus b by 2 upon cos b by 2, which is nothing but RHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS is proved. So in this type of sum, students, again and again, I am reiterating our fundamental aspect. We say that a plus b plus c is equal to pi is to be used as and when required. So this much, students, we have to very perfectly understand. Now, students, fifth sum. I am doing sum number fifth.
Now it is easy to get one term from more number of terms. I am starting the sum from RHS and it is B minus C by A cos A by 2. Fifth sum, I am starting from RHS B minus C by A into, it is nothing but cos of A by 2. Okay, we have to go and teach students. We cannot rush out. Otherwise, maybe then we might make some mistake. Now, B minus C by A is the application of sine rule. Taking K common, sine B minus sine C upon K times sine A into cos A by 2, so this K, K gets cancelled. Now S minus S is 2CX 2 cos of B plus A by 2 and sin of B minus A by 2 cos of A by 2, this is 2 sin A by 2 cos A by 2. So this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Now, what is our answer? We want sin B minus C by 2. This term is our answer. And cos A by 2 and cos A by 2 again stands cancelled. Now again we know B plus C is equal to pi minus A. B plus C by 2 is equal to pi by 2 minus A by 2 cos B plus C by 2 is equal to cos pi by 2 minus A by 2 and that is equal to sin A by 2. So sin A by 2 and cos B plus C by 2 stands cancelled. So final answer is sin of B minus C by 2, which is our LHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Let's prove. We started from RHS, so I have written RHS is equal to LHS. Okay, students, let us do sum number 6. Last sum for today. Remaining questions, students, we will do in the next lecture. Okay, the question reads as A through B cos C. Question 6, LHS is equal to A into B cos C minus C cos B. Now what easily strikes when we read the sum? Applying sine rule will not help us to simplify. But if I go for simple expansion and write this as AB into cos C and AC into cos B. So now I can visualize the application of cosine rule because my final answer should be required in terms of A given BC. For AC. So applying cos rule, I will get cos C as A square plus B square minus C square upon 2AB. And if I apply cos sine rule here, A square plus C square minus B square upon 2AC. So AC, AC gets cancelled. AB gets cancelled, 2 is the common LCM. So A square plus B square minus C square minus A square minus C square plus B square. So A square and A square stands cancelled. B square plus b square twice b square minus twice c square by 2. So the answer is b square minus b square, which is our RHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Hence, true. So, students, here the basic application of the formula is to be understood. And the Grunert type of sums always, but inbuilt condition given is a plus b plus c is equal to pi. Write this formula as 5 times, do the sums twice. The remaining thing will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, students.